Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Organisms and Environment. In that, we are studying topic Hazards of Water Pollution. When I say hazards, it means the ill effects of water pollution or what damage water pollution can cause. Let us study. When I say water pollution, a simple definition comes in your mind that the water body has been contaminated by various pollutants, which could be solid, liquid, and it is not fit for consumption either for human beings nor for animals. When we see any water body which is contaminated, it is going to have impact on your health if you consume that. Basically, there are four different categories on which the effects of water pollution on the whole biosphere can be calculated or can be subdivided. First is effect on agricultural land or on agriculture. Second is effect on environment. Third is effect on industries. And fourth is domestic effect of water pollution. Let us talk about domestic effects of water pollution. When I say domestic effects, if you consume a water which has a lot of sodium lauryl sulfate, that is, whenever you wash your clothes with the detergent, the chemical that mixes with the water body, if you're washing your chemicals in a river or a pond, is sodium lauryl sulfate, and that detergent is very harmful for your respiratory tract. Even certain chemicals which are present in shampoos, soaps, all those can add up to pollutant level in water bodies. So bathing and washing of kettles should be strictly prohibited inside water bodies. Next is your effect on agriculture. Imagine a water body in which a lot of industrial waste, a lot of chemical waste, mercuric oxide, zinc oxide, chloroform chemicals have been dumped. And if a farmer or a gardener uses the same water to put on his crops or to water his plants, don't we think so that this water will be directly transferred to the fruit and the crop? And if we consume those crops, we could be affected. Nowadays, it has been observed that whatever crops are grown beside railway tracks are basically containing mercuric oxide, especially the green vegetables grown around. And whenever we use such water to put water to the crops, obviously the crops will have ill effect on our health. Next is effect on the environment. If water body starts getting polluted and there starts time, imagine there would be a point in everybody's life when there will be no water available on earth, precisely fresh water available for consumption. There will be only salty water available, which is not fit for consumption. So we need to preserve our water bodies so that they are available in the long run for our consumption. Lastly, effect on industries. We all know that every industry rely on water bodies for the various processes. I mean, every chemical process requires water as a substitute. So if the water bodies are damaged at any point of time, all your agro industries will come to a standstill. When I say hazards of water pollution can have ill effects on various phases of life, and one of the phases is effect on agriculture. When I talk about agriculture, wastewater containing mercury, lead can gain entry in ecosystem by the medium of plants. If the water is polluted and if the farmer uses the same water to put on the crops, obviously it will gain entry into the plant ecosystem or plant kingdom. Effect on environment. Polluted water bodies can disturb the water cycle, or you can say the normal water pattern in atmosphere, the way water cycles are formed from water vapors and then in the air and then rain comes out. That cycle could be disturbed. Domestic effects. When I talk about domestic effects, consumption of polluted waters can cause respiratory diseases, and this respiratory diseases can even cause diseases of bronchi, alveoli, colon cancer in children, whereas in adults they can cause dysentery, vomiting and all such symptoms. So polluted water bodies can not only harm the nature but to human beings also. Lastly, industries could go and get huge loss in the terms of production or monetary gains if water is not available as a raw material for production. We all know that for every chemical reaction, majority of them require water for dilution and all such purposes. Pharmaceutical industries, chemical industries, cosmetic industries rely on water as one of its solubilizing agents. So fresh water is not available, even those industries could incur a huge loss, and ultimately economy would suffer. Students, it is our whole and sole responsibility as a citizen of any country wherever you are residing to protect the water bodies and to just be away from the ill effects of pollution of water. I hope you all are clear with this concept. Thank you.